Hello there, zany friend. Now for today's announcements, how to maximize your routine for your Animal Crossing's New Horizons Island. Follow these easy steps to get the most materials and goodies every single day. Step 1. Check your mail. You never know when a friend might leave you something to pick up later. Step 2. Go to Resident Services. Be sure to check for notices, rummage through the recycle bin, and use the ABM. This is a good time to purchase a ticket with your Nook Miles, and look around for any items that rotate in and out of Nook Shopping. You can purchase up to 5, so it's best to purchase 5 each time. Step 3. Go check with the Trash Pandas over at Nook's Cranny. Oh, and not just for the furniture, either. If you check over with the cabinet, it should have items that change every single day, including seeds and umbrellas. Step 4. Stop by the Able Sisters boutique, and make sure to make time for Sable. She starts out shy, but later gives you great fabric patterns. Even if you like your current look, you should still take a look around the shop. You never know when you might find your next signature style. Just to save time, put a wardrobe outside of the Able Sisters for a quick change. Step 5. Run around the island and talk to your special visitors. Each one offers their own products and events that you can only do with them around. Take special note of Daisy May, who sells turnips that you can turn around for a good profit. Step 6. Now that you have the lay of the land, check your Nook Miles tasks and see if there's any activities you need to give more time to. Go ahead and collect those miles. You've earned them. Great! It's time to harvest all your materials for the day. You can do all steps 7 through 13 at the same time. Step 7. Go hunt for fossils in areas where the ground is pushed up. Usually, there are 4 per day. Step 8. Shake the trees for money and fruit. Make sure that you have the net equipped to deal with those pesky wasps. Those are worth 2,500 bells. Typically, there are 5 of them, and 2 special items you can find lurking in the leaves. Step 9. Use the stone axe to harvest wood from your trees without chopping them down. Leave the materials where they're at, as markers in case your axe breaks. That way, you know exactly where you left off. Step 10. Strike rocks with your shovel, but use the 3 behind trick. Dig holes behind yourself before hitting so you don't slide away and miss out on all the goodies. Usually there are about 5 rocks, with 1 being your money rock. Step 11. Take a moment to run through the leaves, for fun. This is a game after all. Step 12. Pick up the shells, coral, clams, and messages in bottles while you have your fishing rod in hand. Clams can be used to make fish food, which spawns fish wherever you want. Great for getting those rare catches. Step 13. Check your Critterpedia and do one last loop for bugs you might need. Keep an eye out for floating presents, lost items, and weeds while you're at it. You can carry a lot of weeds, so it never hurts. Step 14. Now that your pockets are full of materials, go ahead and craft any new recipes you received. It's a great way to fill up your catalog and get a few more miles. Step 15. Go on over to Blathers in the museum and have him assess your fossils. Donate any that he doesn't have. Then sell off anything you don't need to Nook's Cranny. This is also a good time to check turnip prices and sell those off. Wow. Step 16. Now that you have a bunch of cash, go pay off your debt to Tom or make donations to Lloyd for any renovations. Step 17. Water your flowers. If you've laid them out properly, this will encourage your blooms to produce hybrids. Step 18. Wherever you see a glowing spot, dig it up to get a bag of bells. Then, bury up to 10,000 bells in the same spot. This will make a nursery money tree. And go ahead and dig that up. You can transplant it in place of your old one. You'll get more bells for a larger investment, but it isn't effective past 10,000. Step 19. Go around and talk to all the residents that you like. Return lost items and gift unneeded clothes. They sometimes give you items or money in return. Besides, they're always happy to see you. If you're having trouble finding one, check for them in the Able Sisters. They might be on a shopping trip. Step 20. It's time to trash the Mystery Islands. Empty out your pockets first, though. There's plenty of resources, and you don't have to worry about replenishing them. Though, prioritize stuff that isn't native to your island. Keep in mind what resources are native to your island, so you know where best to sell them. Save native fruits for Friends Island, and non-native go to your local nooks. Save coconuts for when you need to break rocks and dig up trees. That's all for now. I hope you all enjoy the loveliest of lovely days, and stay zany!